move on what I am here to present you today, because it's mainly related with the activity of a high representative together with my vice chairman of the European Commission, is the joint communication Commission plus High Representative on the new European Union-US agenda for global change. It is the first formalized institutional message to our partners in the US about the importance that we are putting onto our transatlantic relations and about our suggestions where and how we could move together to make the world a better place. This communication will fit into discussions by ministers of the Foreign Affairs Council next Monday, and then by European Union leaders at the European Council later next week. Everybody knows that the European Union and the US are the two closest partners and allies, bound by values, historical links, and shared objectives. It is no more important and more strategic partner for the European Union than the US. And the agenda formulates priorities for a revamped transatlantic partnership from our perspective on several areas. Areas where our interests converge, areas where our collective leverage can be best used, and areas where our global leadership is required. At the core of this agenda is a united, capable, and self-reliant European Union, which is good for Europe, good for the transatlantic partnership, and for the multilateral system. More in detail, a coronavirus response to work together to a healthier world is an invitation to the US to join the European Union global leadership role in promoting cooperation in response to the coronavirus, reopening our economies and societies as fast as possible, and jointly reinforce and reform the World Health Organization. Second, climate leadership. This means working together to protect our planet and prosperity. We want to focus on climate change and loss of biodiversity as the defining challenges of our time. It's clear that we need a shared commitment to a net zero emission pathway by 2050, prior to COP26 next year, and we need to collaborate with the US to propose a climate initiative within the World Trade Organization. Third, trade and technology. Trade and tech. This is about working together on technology, trade and standards. It's very much needed that we join forces as technological allies to shape technologies, to set up norms, and to use our regulatory environment. And finally, global action. Here the focus is on working together towards a safer, more prosperous, and more democratic world. It reaffirms the objective of a geopolitical commission, reflects aspirations to a greater strategic autonomy, not contradictory with having a strong transatlantic partnership, strengthening relations with our key world partner. This is the three objectives: geopolitical commission, aspirations to greater strategic autonomy, and a strengthening relation with our key world partner. The US has been demanding for the European Union to take more responsibility for its own matter, and this that's what we want to do. We need to continue working on our capabilities to enable the European Union to become a strong global partner, in particular for the European Union-US relations in complementarity with NATO. We want more cooperation on external affairs. We want to restore and strengthen the global rules-based order and multilateralism. We want to make multilateralism greater again, and also to deal with conflicts and challenges all around the world. And we will now invite the European Council to endorse this agenda for global change. and it could be then launched at an European Union-US summit in the first half of next year. This is going to be discussed at the Foreign Affairs Council next week.